Good morning, dear students. Welcome in social science class. Dear students, in previous topics, we have completed our pollutants in the environment or air. Then after we have done the relation between the atmospheric pressure and temperature. After that, we have done the wind and importance of wind. And today we will start our next topic, mechanism of rainfall. That is mechanism of rainfall. Or in simple words, we can say that water cycle. Many times you have read in previous classes as well, in science as well as in social science. I hope this topic is not that much difficult you to understand. As the hot air rises, it reaches high in the atmosphere where it cools down due to the presence of low temperature there. Yes, when we can say that low temperature on the surface or in the water areas, we have low temperature. But when the high rays or heat of the sun will comes on the surface, the evaporation process go up. This one is evaporation process. This one also, the transpiration also a kind of evaporation. It is through plants and it is through water. Thus, the water present in the form of water vapors condenses into tiny droplets of water or crystals. These tiny droplets, these water vapors, when evaporation occurs, small water vapors moving upward, but they are transparent. It is not visible by the naked eyes. That's why what happened, these water vapors go upward in the sky and they can form a cloud. They can form a cloud. And cloud formation is known as condensation. In due course of time, these tiny particles join together and form clouds. Due to further cooling, these tiny condensed droplets join and form larger droplets. What happens? They can retain over there and then collecting water vapors and moisture from the evaporation. And ultimately what happened, they become so heavy and not able to retain themselves in the sky. In course of time, these droplets become so heavy that the air cannot hold them. And hence, when they collide with each other, when the clouds collide with each other, the rain comes down. And rain, in other words, we are saying that precipitation. They fall down as a rainfall or snowfall depending upon the atmospheric temperature of the region. What kind of atmospheric temperature is there? Very high or very low temperature? Because sometimes where we have water bodies or sea land, we can say that the temperature of the surface is quite low and their pressure is high, because yesterday we have discussed the temperature where we have higher temperature, lower is the air pressure, and where we have low temperature, the higher is the air pressure. It works in an opposite manner. And then rain or precipitation occurs, then surface runoff also there. Some water is running on the surface, some water is coming from the soil, and some water is going inside the earth, that is known as underground water. Next, the rainfall is very important to all of us, as it brings water to the earth, which is essential for the survival of all kinds of life on the earth's surface. Because if water is not there, then life cannot be possible. But it should be in a proper manner. If the rainfall is scarce or very low, then it causes drought and shortage of water will be there. And on the other hand, if excessive rainfall is there, then also it will create a problem of floods. On the other hand, do you know the rainfall can be measured with the help of an instrument called rain gauge? Look at the instrument rain gauge. The unit of measuring rainfall is centimeter or millimeter. Measuring rainfall, how much rainfall occurs in particular place in centimeters or in millimeters. So student, this was all about today's topic, water cycle. This much we can do today, and this monitoring weather condition, where the difference between the weather and climatic condition will continue in the next video. So for this, thank you, good day, and stay safe.